Let's go to the US now. Donald Trump worked at McDonald's this week in the final weeks of the campaign. That was in Pennsylvania, by no mistake. Kamala Harris appeared on stage with Stevie Wonder in Georgia, two of the crucial swing states. Joining me live is former White House Chief of Staff and now Bondi Partners consultant Mick Mulvaney. Great to see you. Six or seven swing states, a few little surprises. The polls are tightening. Mick, what does it look like at the moment?
Extraordinarily tight. There's a reason you're seeing them pull out all the stops now with Donald Trump pulling, you know, let's call it what it is. It's a political stunt. I happen to like it as a political stunt, but that's exactly what it is in Pennsylvania. And of course, going on stage with celebrities is a big thing Democrats have done here for a long time in the closing weeks of elections. So I think I did television here last week before I came down to see you in Australia. And on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, Donald Trump was winning a poll in Pennsylvania. And on Tuesday and Thursday, Kamala Harris was winning the exact same poll. So that's just how close it is here, Laura.
All right. So that's why a couple of weeks ago they've turned to their base. It all comes down to turnout in many, many senses.
Absolutely. I don't think there's any undecided voters left. There might be a couple. I talked to the head of the Republican National Committee about their efforts to get out the vote. And here it's traditional to knock on people's doors and encourage them to vote. Ordinarily, you just walk through a neighborhood and do that to everybody. Now the Republicans are doing it only to people that they really believe are going to actually get out to vote for Donald Trump. The Democrats are doing something similar. So It is a turnout election. Again, bears repeating that voting is not compulsory here in the United States. So getting your people out to the polls is critical. Over 15 million people have already voted. Early voting has started in a couple of states, including my own state here in South Carolina, where voting started today. So the turnout is expected to be historic.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's what they want. But it also matters if the turnout happens in those six or seven swing states. The popular vote doesn't matter in many ways, like our election here in Queensland and federally coming up. But you mentioned the Democrats have, for a long time, they wheel out the celebrities. Is that a good idea?
You know, it doesn't hurt. I'm not sure anybody sits around and says to themselves, oh, my goodness, I wonder who Stevie Wonder is voting for. But it does make for good television. Look, this is all designed to get what we call earned media or free media, which is news stories, cable television, online folks covering you without you having to pay for it. It's the reason that Donald Trump brought out the wrestler Hulk Hogan at the Republican National Convention. It's part and parcel of the system here. Television advertising is extraordinarily expensive. I think the combined campaigns will spend more than $1 billion on television in just the swing states, if you can believe that. So getting on TV here is critical, and certainly celebrities help that.
I thought Barack Obama, Michelle Obama ramping up their appearances and rallies was particularly interesting, but I question the wisdom of Barack Obama chastising black men in particular, saying sexism is an issue. How's that going to go down?
Yeah, that's a tough one. Listen, both campaigns are doing it. Donald Trump came out and said he was going to cap interest rates on credit cards. That runs the risk of upsetting fiscal conservatives like myself. When Barack Obama, but they're counting, the Republicans are counting on me still voting for Donald Trump and then adding some people who might like that credit card policy. Barack Obama coming out and chastising African-American males for being sexist, saying to them and waving his finger at them, saying, I don't think you want to vote for a woman. That's a really dangerous thing to do because it might turn off those voters. But they're gambling, the Democrats are, that those folks will still vote for Kamala Harris and they'll pick up some votes with the message that that Kamala Harris is a candidate for all genders.
What's the pull of Barack Obama and Michelle Obama now? Obviously, it's not as strong as when he was president, but where does he go down the best?
Yeah, well, go back to your original point. This is a turnout election. It doesn't swing any, certainly Republican voters to show up. It doesn't swing any undecided voters. But if you're trying to get your people, your base to show up, Barack Obama is a celebrity in his own right. So those are the reasons to have folks like that come out. You see Bill Clinton campaigning now in Pennsylvania. The old Democrat names get out the Democrat base. It's pretty standard stuff, but it's really in high gear now here.
Mick, I'm not going to ask for your prediction on November 5 because that would be very unfair. But who's got the momentum?
Yeah, if the election was 2 weeks ago, I would have given it to Kamala Harris. I think today, if the election were today, it would be Donald Trump. 2 weeks is an eternity, especially with a race as tight as this is. But I think if the election were today, the momentum is with Donald Trump. We'll see if he can keep that up for the last 2 weeks or not.
Yeah, what's Frank Luntz saying at the moment?
You know, I haven't talked to Frank since the night of the debate. He said that Donald Trump was absolutely going to lose and that he lost the debate that night. I think he's been eating a little bit of crow in the last couple of weeks. So we'll see what happens.
Well, let's have one of those dinners again in D.C. when I see you. Mick, thanks so much.
In a few weeks.